Salam sejahtera, selamat malam, good evening everyone. Tajia wan sang hao, panakem. Dia ada satu syarikat yang memulakan dengan vending machine. Dan saya rasa dia pun latar belakangnya agak menarik ya. Dia start sudah dari sejak kecil 12 tahun sudah mula bekerja sebagai mengendalikan makanan ya, child labor ke buruh kanak-kanak ya. So malam ini kita welcome Evelyn Fu ya.
Hi, thank you for the invitation. Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera. I'm Evelyn Fu from Vagnology. We are a Penang startup company also based in Malaysia.
Okay, good. How about Evelyn? Yeah, can you share with us?
So, actually, startup, when you establish a startup, you need to come with a solution to solve a particular problem. So just like just now Saudara mentioned, he actually solving a problem. So Vagnology, the original idea to start Vagnology is quite funny. So every time I talk about this story, I also feel quite easy and funny. So one day, me and my co-founder is feel hungry in our university. So back to 2015. So that time we've come up with one idea. Hey, why the canteen is not open and why there is no canteen operate after 5 p.m. or before 8 a.m. We need to go for exam at 8, so we need to go for 7:30. So we think about one idea. Why no food vending machines? Why the vending machine in the Malaysia back to 2015 before is all about canned drinks and all about those bottled drinks. There is no food or non-food. Even don't not F&B vending machine we cannot find in Malaysia. So that time, we started the first idea, which is we want to solve the university student hunger problem. So we started the vending machine business. Back to 2015, we actually is a vending machine operator. We actually operating a vending machine in our university. So when come to 2016 year end, we already graduate from our university. So we think about, hey, it's time we come up for work. So we need to like stop the vending machine operations. So we need to sell the vending machine to others. So when during that time, actually we plan to close down Vagnology. To be honest, we don't want to run the Vagnology anymore. Hey, who want to buy Vagnology? Come on, come and buy. So that time, a lot of people start text us when we sell the Vagnology. They say, I don't want to buy your company. I want to buy vending machines. So we started to make some research and also ask them feedback. Why you buy vending machine from me? I want to sell my company. Why you come and buy our company? Why you don't buy my company? So they say, actually that time Malaysia, there is no vending machine supplier doing the sales and services. So this is what my customer feedback to me. So this is the reason we, after graduate, we don't work for people. We start Vagnology to trading the vending machines. And the vending machine that we are trading is actually from China at that moment. So once we're doing the trading vending machine until 2018, we realized one problem. If we keep trading the vending machine, it's actually import from China and sell in Malaysia. It's import more than export. In the macro economy, you know, that is actually not growing our GDP. So what we're going to do is we would like to build Malaysia vending machine. So our vending machine right now is actually made in Malaysia fully from the hardware to software. So what we are focusing and what our mission doing is actually we would like to target in the Southeast Asia with the Malaysian made vending machines. So okay, sure about the success story. Actually, for us, we have two sides of success story. One is our customer success story. It's also our success story and also our own success story. So of course, our own success story is as a startup, we join a lot of program and competitions. So we actually shortlisted in the South Korea, where it's the top 60 startup in the South Korea about the technology and also the business model. It's called KSGC. So Malaysia actually only two startup been selected for these competitions, for the final competitions. And also last year, we joined about Malaysia Global Innovation and Creative Center, and we also shortlisted at the top 30 in the Global Accelerator Program. So this is just a side of Vagnology success story. But for us, the things that we most happy is how our customer can success. So my customer base is actually quite a different industry. Some of them is actually pet food. Some of them is actually personal protection equipment. Some of them is actually those essential products like shampoo. And also, of course, a lot of them is selling the ready to eat food. So what their reason is actually they already have their product. But if let's say they're going through all those products to those mini market or maybe to supermarket, for them it's actually very high cost. Or if they open a kedai in a supermarket, actually it's a very high operating expenses. They need to hire people, they need to pay for the shop rental. So they actually use the vending machine as their extra distribution channel to actually target in different location with a high volume. So we are very mission in helping our customer. That means that we need to help them to scale up and also let their product get more exposure in the market. So I have two success stories. I have one customer doing the pet food back to 2016. He actually have many pet food kiosks last time, and he actually dismantle all the kiosk and become 20 vending machine in the Klang Valley area. So he only hired like one staff to manage all the 20 location instead of 20 location hired like 40 staff. So he able to scale up, and his mission also very good since he can cut down his rental. His actually product selling cheaper. He actually selling like 1 ringgit per pet food. So you can actually feed the stray cats and stray dogs. If you see the kucing, meow, 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 and then you don't need to give them nasi kandar. Like actually, you can buy 1 ringgit. So actually, yeah, we help him, and he actually helping those public also. So how we software and hardware to help my customer. So my software actually different a bit with the traditional vending machine. We come with the AI technology and also with the enterprise resources planning system, inventory management system. So they can actually use the vending machine to control their supply chain instead of just get a vending machine and just sell and earn money. So as well as we are focusing in the cashless payment system, so they actually can reduce the risk and also the time to collect all the cash and coin. If let's say they want to run the business, actually everything is more transparent and trackable through system, and the system is real time. So this is the customer feedback. They can say that, hey, your machine is actually helping my business to actually scale up and also doing better. And good thing is actually because people stay at home and nothing to do, right? So they start search online, like, what is the things that they can help them during the MCO? For those SME, small medium enterprise, they actually have their product cannot deliver. So they think about vending machines. And some of people, their individual client in micro enterprise, they can, they job and then they pay cut. So they think about, hey, I can earn passive income through the vending machines. I can put the vending machine in the condo. So those people, after 7 p.m., they cannot go to the supermarket, and then I can just grab a cup me or whatever food in the vending machine in the, my lobby. So, but they need to sanitize that regularly. So how to reduce all these risks? We have to think about cash is an issue also. So because, of course, social distancing is a problem, wear mask is a problem, but actually cash is also transmitting the virus. If let's say people cough and then they touch the money. I got one experience during MCO, I go and tap out a food. So that time I tap out a food and then I wait, I queue in the hawker, so I keep the social distance. But I saw the buyer, I mean the customer in front of me, and then he suddenly coughed. And then he take, you know, people cough, they take off the mask, you know, then they put the mask here. So we take off and then he cough, and then when he cough, he actually use the mask like this. So you can hear the voices, no matter it's COVID or not COVID, like it's normal flu also, okay. It will feel a bit because now we already know that, oh, so scary. And then after that, the hawker tell him, okay, 2 ringgit, 50 cents, something like this. And then he take out the money and then he give to the hawker. And the hawker is like cooking. And then he take the money and then he just put in the pocket and then he continue to get the meal, la, noodle, la, whatever things. So you will feel, when I'm the customer next behind, I will feel that you touch the food, la, and the food you're going to, I mean, some of the food is not, you touch and then you cook, you know, it's a dessert, you know. So it's actually, you don't go to boiling temperature. So I feel scared, but he already cooked my things. La. So he say, ah, yours one, that 3 ringgit. So I ask him, do you have e-wallet? Then they say, no lah, hawker mama got e-wallet. So I said, oh, okay. Then I open my wallet, I see 50 ringgit. Oh shit, I need to get back my change some more. I cannot give, take the change, cannot. Okay, at the end, I still give 50 ringgit. Of course, I got wash my hand, I got sanitized and everything. I got bath after I go home. But to be honest, this is one thing that new norm is actually practicing cashless. That's why the government is actually pushing e-penjana. They're giving the 50 ringgit for all the rakyat because they want to pushing towards the cashless society. And also, they want to push towards the social distancing, wear masks and everything. So all this is new norm. And wear masks become a new norm. Social distancing become a new norm. Cashless become new norm. And this combined together actually is actually benefit our industry. That's why we receive a lot of calls and inquiries when we my staff work from home. Because people start thinking, if your machine is cashless, then your machine is actually no manpower to handle. I don't need to worry about, I need to, my worker cannot come to work, whatever things. And the third thing is, actually you can sell masks through vending machine. So Actually, as a startup, usually a startup is not like SME, because usually you run a small business and then you will go into micro enterprise and then you go to the small medium enterprise. So usually this kind of process, you will go from 10 to 100 to 300. But to be honest, startup also, we know that startup only go big or go home only. So if you are less than 20 staff, you can consider startup lah that time. So, that is the question lah. Berapa lama perniagaan mampu berfungsi? Before MCO, just announce the MCO, we are quite shocked. Because that time we don't know, can we really bertahan under this protocol kecemasan? Is it we can tahan, can go through the MCO? We don't know how long the COVID-19 going to end. So endless, maybe 1 year or 2 years. So can we sustain lah? Like cannot production every day or then cannot do sales or? So we were actually quite afraid, like our payroll, our cash flow, everything. So that time, if you ask me this question, you ask me on April, I cannot answer you. I maybe answer you maybe today. I can answer maybe you today. Because you don't know the future. But luckily, like after April, May, we can really see that the government pushing a lot of the initiative. And also once they push the e-Penzana, and then the e-wallet industry is actually growing. And also because of the new norm, like just now I say, social distance, cashless, and the personal protection equipment. Actually, the whole vending machine industry is actually growing. And also new report in the Asia Pacific is actually showing that the vending machine in Asia Pacific also will be growing together. It's not only in Malaysia. is affecting the whole Asia. So we can say that technology is disrupting. So in startup, there is one word called disrupt. Disrupt sounds like, macam ganasnya, macam bunuh orang kan. But actually, disrupt is actually one word in the startup industry ecosystem. It's actually mentioned that innovate, but it's not friendly innovate. Actually, technology come up, they disrupt another industry. Just like Netflix is actually disrupt the VCD industry. So Uber and Grab is actually disrupting the taxi industry. So all these things is actually, you can say, is it Uber ganas? You can say Netflix ganas. But actually there is a new change and this must be changed in the world. People keep improving. Back to 30 years ago in our grandfather and your father generation, is actually that time you won't hear about internet. You won't think about pen drive. You won't think about cloud system. You won't think about Google. But today, actually, they're coming up, they're actually disrupting the traditional business. So as a startup industry people or the normal consumer, this thing is what we have to adapt and also what we have to understand. When a new technology come up, it's actually disrupting. So Anna, to you actually also disrupting, because to be honest, when he come out these things, actually a lot of people might be losing job because they say that now more convenient mah. So they no need hire so many teacher, or maybe they no need go through so many process. They no need hire so many clerk to do all these things. So actually also disrupting. So you will say, they lost the job opportunity. But actually when new technology come up, it create more opportunity. They just transform. Last time you got the becha people, right? Becha, they actually riding the becha and then they fetch you to the school. Last time you won't, maybe we don't have car, maybe we don't have Uber taxi. They use becha to fetch those kindergarten or primary school people to go to their school. But now actually they already changed. Are we disrupting the batch? Yes. But are we actually improving? Yes, also. So same like vending machine. Actually, the offline retailing, they're having a lot of problem in scale up their business and also running a lot of the manpower issue, HR issue, like routine turnover. They always have many turnover issue. People resign and don't want to do off this job. Actually, vending machine also help them. So vending machine sounds like disrupting the offline industry. But actually, we are helping the offline industry to scale up in a better way.
The side question, your vending machine can put like char kway teow, prawn mee, all this can put in vending machine. Can or not?
There is a lot of vending machine in the market. You can see people use vending machine sell car. They can actually sell ramen, sell orange juice, and also sell pizza. But because we are made in Malaysia and we are not that Japan level yet, so we actually can dispense a package product. So the product need to come with package. You can sell masks, you can sell spanner, but everything need to come with a package. So without a package, we cannot dispense nicely and also we might have mistake lah. So if let's say you want to sell a chubby hoon and everything, yes, you can actually pack with a packaging container lah, or those like newspaper, you can actually wrap like this. But another thing to concern, how long is your shelf life? If your shelf life is just like 2 hours, 3 hours, do you need to replenish regularly? If your shelf life like cold pressed juice, just one day, so the next day you might need to throw all your unsell item. So this is all the things to consider. Shelf life is quite important. So that's why a lot of people start to ask about the frozen vending machines, microwave vending machine. Yeah, because they think that the shelf life is longer. And during this period, actually, I received quite a Malaysia brand, very good brand. I cannot mention their name. They actually got their own ready-to-eat food, but not in frozen temperature. It's just normal room temperature. And they can store up to 1 year. Then you might imagine, is it a lot of preservative? But the use of technology is no preservative at all. They actually use quite a special packaging, like astronaut. If let's say the astronaut, they want to fly to the Mars, right? Then they will have a certain packaging of product. Now, that kind of technology. But I'm not sure because I'm not in the food industry. So they have the food testing and also food packaging technology can actually help to store the food in a room temperature and with a longer shelf life. So they also think about vending machine.
They call retort technology, I think. Retort. The food they can keep for 1 month. 1 year. Yeah, not 1 month, 1 year.
I quite inspired when I listen to this. Can I? Can eat man?
Can retort or not?
Okay.
Di France dulu saya selalu lah setahun punya Brahim dulu pakai Brahim kan, all the packaging the Brahim and then the one that they make kapal terbang punya food right. Brahim lah, you buy Brahim, it's dalam plastik semua, you makan setahun saya boleh pakai simpan bila saya pergi.
I don't even cook at home to be honest.
One wonderful holiday tomorrow ya. So tomorrow is a awal Muharram. So okay, thank you semua. Okay, kita jumpa lagi. Thanks.
Thank you, Daniel. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.
Bye. Good night. 谢谢大家. 晚安.
Thank you.
Wanakam. Nandri wanakam.